Hi, I'm Dennis Rodkin. I write the Deal Estate column for Chicago Magazine, and this is DEQs, where I answer real estate questions from readers. A reader named Barry asks, do you have any advice relating to the potential liability to repay the difference between the short sale proceeds and mortgage balance due? This is a sticky legal question, so I consulted an attorney who deals with these sorts of things, Matthew Hector, who's at Suleiman Law Group in Oak Brook. And one of the primary things he pointed out is that the mortgage balance left unpaid in a short sale is not as easy to shake in Illinois as it is in states like California, where walkaways have been more common. The reason for that is that Illinois is a recourse state. That means that the bank or the lender can come after the short seller later for recourse or collection of that money that was unpaid. And while for the most part, banks in Illinois and particularly in Chicago have not been going after those deficiencies, there's no reason to believe that they never will. As Matthew Hector points out, Bank of America has just installed this fee for using your debit card. Banks need to turn a profit, and they're looking for ways to do so. There's no reason to believe that they will never come after all that money they've left hanging in short sales in Illinois. Hector says that the three best ways to avoid worrying, will the bank come after me someday, is to go for one of these things: a deed in lieu of foreclosure, a consent foreclosure, or bankruptcy. All of these are spelled out on his blog, which we've posted at chicagomag.com/foreclosureblog, but it's also something you can talk about with another attorney who has experience in these kinds of things, and that's a good thing to do. Next week, I'll answer Barry's follow-up question, which has to do with bankruptcy as it relates to a short sale. Thanks for your questions. Send me more at dennis@rodkin.com.